Friends, coming to the chapter number 3, from gathering to growing food. So this chapter discusses more about the eating habits. Today, it says that today we eat the food which is like fruits, vegetables, grain, milk, meat. All of these come from reared animals and plants. So, but this was not earlier the case. It gives information from the perspective of UPSC first that rice requires more water than wheat. So different plants needed different conditions. So first is rice needs more water than wheat and barley. This explains why farmers grow some crops in some areas and not in other areas. We know that the areas where water is more available, if this is India, the coastal areas grow more rice, and while the middle part is more towards wheat and barley because the water is not available. Apart from that, animals also prefer some environments, like sheep and goat can survive more easily and better in dry and hilly environment than cattle. So the beginning of farming and herding had begun. There is nothing much in this paragraph. So the factual information of our importance starts from here. That first animal to be tamed was the wild ancestor of the dog. So first animal to be tamed was dog. So this is a factual information which can be used anytime in our prelims. Apart from that, it says that relatively gentle animals were tamed, like sheep, goat, cattle, and pig. They lived in herds and near the camps of humans and ate grass. So apart from this, the domestic, what does the word domestication mean? So domestication is a term which means that process by which people grow plants and look after animals. So we know that most of the animals and plants are wild, but once human beings tame over it, then it is known as domestication. Example, there are numerous animals like wild dogs, wild ass. These are very large in size, and here you can see this is the teeth of a domesticated pig and this is the teeth of a wild pig. So these are much larger in size. Apart from that, humans needed those plants which had large grains, strong stalks, and capable of bearing the weight of ripe grains. So all these were required for a plant to become tamed or domesticated. Example of domesticated grains are like wheat, barley, and rice. All these are examples. And domestication as a process started around 12,000 years ago. Another factual information comes here that domestication began about 12,000 years ago, and virtually all plants and animals produced we have today are being domesticated at that time. Example, wheat, barley, sheep, goat, I have told you earlier. Coming to the next paragraph, a new way of life. It gives a very generic view where it says that a seed is used as seed, as food, as gift, as stored. It is also stored as a food. Apart from that, it says that because men had seeds, they started a very sedentary life where they had to look after the plants, watering, weeding, driving away animals and birds. So all this led to the sedentary settlement of man. And they also had to make clay pots because they had to store this grain. So this is just a idea about how things came up. Then this storing of animals. So animals multiply naturally. They give us not only food but milk and meat and other things. So nothing much of importance. Here also next paragraph is also not much of importance. Here the term burnt grain is you can read. It says that the evidence of grain is found when they are accidentally burnt or charred and the imprints are left. So here we can understand that yes, agriculture had started. This particular table is very important from UPSC point of view, because here you can also apply your earlier knowledge. Earlier we have seen that rice needs more water than wheat. So here you can see that Mehrgarh is in Pakistan. Wheat would be there is paucity of water. Like this, like Koldi Hawa. So this is an important hawa. This is an important place, a site. So you can make mnemonics or you can apply any of the methods to remember it. Like I have remembered it like hawa ke jitni polity change hoti hai Uttar Pradesh ke andar and bahut hi fragmented polity hai. So you know fragmentary animal bones are found there. So similarly you can learn what is found where. So few of the important sites are like Mahagra, Gurfkral, Burza Home, Chirand in present day Bihar, Hallur in Andhra Pradesh and Payampalli in Andhra Pradesh. So these are few sites which you need to remember. Apart from that, Burza Home is a very important site. Here you find pit houses. So pit houses were the dug houses. So this is the ground level. These people used to dig their house around two rooms and there used to be a staircase. So this was done why? To prevent, to save themselves from cold weather. So this was a shelter in cold weather and cooking was also done both inside and outside depending on the weather. So the pit houses is a specialty of this site, Burza Home. Some of the tools here have been found like these were very different from the earlier Paleolithic tools. So this is why these are known as Neolithic. As you have seen in the earlier map in chapter 2, there was this map. This is a very important map for both Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic, all these sites. So here you can see the Neolithic sites of Hallur, Payampalli and all these are Mehargarh, Chirand, Burza Home, all these are Neolithic sites. All these are Neolithic sites. So if a question comes, which of these is a Neolithic site or which of these is a Paleolithic site, you know that you can make your answer from this map itself. So apart from this, there is nothing much here. You can see the shapes of these tools. And these tools were used for grinding grains and other hunting and all these things. There is nothing much here. I have read all this and there is nothing much here. You can see one of the things which NCERT does while you read it is that it opens up your perspective. In this line, does things change everywhere and all at once? So it is inculcating a critical thinking in you. So yes, there was changes happening, but it was not everywhere and not all at once. So it was a very gradual process. Coming to the next topic, tribes. So this chapter gives a very generic definition of tribes, that 2 to 3 generations were living together in a small settlement or village and most families are related to one another or group. So this is the generic definition of tribe. So members of tribes followed the occupation of hunting, gathering, farming, herding and fishing, all these things. And they had a culture of singing, dancing, decorating things, unique tradition. All these things are very generic, but important here is that while you are reading it, try searching for schemes on tribals today. So today numerous schemes like Bandhu Jan Kalyan Yojana, and there are programs for saving tribal language. So tribes had a unique language and music and stories. So there are numerous programs run by government for protecting their languages. And the society of tribes are much more egalitarian. So this is a fact. This will come from this point. Coming to the next topic, it's Mehargarh. Mehargarh is the site we have seen in map number 2 on page 14. So this was the site which is near the Bolan Pass. Bolan Pass. Pass is an area between two mountains or hills. So it's very difficult to pass like this. But if a small pass is made, then it is easier for people to pass from one side of the mountains to the other side. So in Mehargarh, wheat, sheep and goats were reared. Apart from that, nothing much is here, but a chronology of finding of animals is there. It says that numerous bones of animals is found, like dig and pig were found much earlier, later sheep and goat, and at the last was found cattle bones. So somehow it gives a semblance of chronology. I have already told you that history is excavated in layers. So the one which is much deeper is much earlier and the above is much later on. So in Mehrgarh is a very important site for this Neolithic era. So it's here the information given is that Mehrgarh had square or rectangular houses, which was made of four or more compartments, and they were used for storage. So apart from that, burial was a very important practice. So life after death and all these things are not new. Rather, these were also in prehistoric times where Mehrgarh people would have been buried with goats so as to serve as a means for food in the next world. So you can here is the picture given where you can see this is the skeleton of a man and these are the two skeletons of goats for his afterlife. So these kind of beliefs were also there. Coming to the end, another site which is unique in its name and location is Daujali Heading. This is a site on hills near Brahmaputra Valley. So routes leading to it's very close to China and Myanmar. Here also stone tools were found, mortars and pestles were found, which were probably used for growing grains, preparing food and other things. A stone, jadeite, is found here, which must have been brought from China. NCERT also opens up the mind of students by pointing out that even Turkey and other had Neolithic sites. So it's not that only India has it, but other countries also have it, like flint from Syria and quarries from Red Sea. So this is an information which could be asked, you know, you can use in maybe obliquely or tangentially, but somewhere, like quarries were from Red Sea. So we know that quarries and shells were used as currency. In later medieval period, they would be used as currency. So important dates we have seen: the beginning of domestication 12,000 years ago and beginning of settlement at Mehrgarh 8,000 years ago. So nothing much here. So this is the end of chapter 3. We would be continuing with chapter 4. Thank you.